Hello, and welcome to Hindsight 101, where you learn about things that will help you in everyday life. Now, if you want to know how to record two individual tracks on the Zoom H6 in Adobe Audition, let's go check it out.
Hello, and welcome. First, I'd like to start with a disclaimer that what I'm going to describe may not be the best way, but it's the only way I figured out to record two individual tracks through the Zoom H6 onto Adobe Audition. So let's go. As you can see, there's six separate tracks, LR 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to change this later. So now you want to go into the menu and you want to select Audio Interface. Once you've selected Audio Interface, you want to select Stereo Mix. You have several different options, PC Mac using the battery power, or iPad using the battery power, the four AA batteries you put into the Zoom H6. Now, once you've selected that, you want to go to MS Matrix. And in MS Matrix, when you saw those individual tracks, now we're going to combine 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. So you want to turn that on for each track. As you can see, the tracks are no longer individual. 1 and 2 are together, and 3 and 4 are together. You want to make sure you have this configuration. Mic 1 is in input 1, and then mic 2 is in input 4. Don't know why, but it works. You also want to turn each input on. So you want to turn 1 and 2 on, and this will be displayed with the lights glowing. Since they're combined, both lights will light up. 3 and 4, the lights are on, they are combined. On a Mac, you want to go into System Preferences and select Sound. From there, you want to select Input, then H6 for Zoom H6. Then you want to control the input volume. Usually I put it around 75%, works well for the mic that I use. Then you close out of here and you go to Adobe Audition. You want to select multi-track. And then from there, you can actually make a template. Say you're doing a podcast, you can make this template every time you start your podcast so you don't have to create this again. Then you want to go to templates. You want to select empty stereo session and not the other ones, because the other ones will pre-populate things for you. The empty stereo will make a blank one so you can create your own. So go to multi-track again, track, add audio track mono. You want to do that again because you're going to have two individual tracks, add mono audio track. So host 1, host 2, and then you have your master at the bottom. Then you're going to want to change the input to mono left, and then you want to do the second one to mono right. And then from there, you want to arm the tracks for recording, so you click on the R for each of the tracks. As you can see here, the tracks are receiving sound simultaneously instead of individually. So I'll show you how to change that now. You want to go back into the settings, go back to MS Matrix, and before we had it on, now we're going to switch it off for each of the tracks, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. I don't know why this works, but it does. So let's go back to Adobe Audition and see the difference this setting makes. So as you can see now, each track has its own individual sound. You may see the tracks move up and down both together, but that's just because, as you can see, I had the mics very close together, so they were getting a little feedback. But they are playing individual tracks now instead of simultaneously. I looked all over the internet to figure out how to do this. Everyone said it could be done, but no one would show you how. So after a lot of trial and error, I was able to figure it out, and hopefully this works for somebody else. But if you have a better way, please share. If you like what you saw, please hit that like button. If you want to see more, please subscribe. Thank you again, and take care.